Good morning everyone. So today we will do the revision of our lesson number 4, that is sorting materials into groups. And before starting this chapter, we should know what are materials and what are objects. In our first chapter, we have already studied that food is made up of one ingredient or more than one ingredient. In the similar manner, object could also be made up of one material or more than one material. So, we can say that an object is a thing that is made of one or more material. An object could be made of one material, for example, wooden chair. A wooden chair could be made of wood. An object could also be made of more than one material, for example, pencil. A pencil could be made of graphite, wood, and if it is a pencil with eraser, so it could be made up of eraser, metal, graphite and wood. So object could be made up of one material and more than one material also. Objects are made up of large variety of materials. For example, a table or chair could be made of wood, plastic or iron. In the similar manner, toys could be made up of wood, plastic or paper. Utensils could be made up of plastic, iron, aluminium, steel. And clothes could be made up of cotton, nylon, silk or rayon. So, a given material could be used to make a large number of objects. For example, wood could be used to make chair, door, board, bed, etc. In the similar manner, wood could be used to make chair, table, bed, door, board, etc. And paper could be used to make books, calendars, newspaper, magazines, etc. Similarly, steel could be used to make vehicles, utensils, and etc. Based on the properties of materials, they are used for making different objects. For example, a tea or coffee mug is always made with clay or plastic and not with cloth material because its purpose is to hold the liquid. And if we use a cup which is made up of cotton or which is made up of a cloth material, so it cannot hold the liquid. So to select the material to make objects, it is very important to select a suitable material to make a particular object. And how can we select the material? We can select the material based on the properties of their materials. And on the basis of their properties, they are used for making different objects. Now we will discuss the properties of materials. So first property is appearance. Appearance is basically how a material looks. And based on appearance, materials are classified into shiny or lustrous material and non-shiny or non-lustrous material. For example, gold, silver, diamond, copper, aluminium, all these are shiny or lustrous material. That is why gold and diamond and silver also used to make jewelry, because they are shiny material. And wood and plastic are non-shiny material, so we cannot use them to make jewelries. So on the basis of this property also, we can select different materials to make a particular object. The next property is hardness or softness. On the basis of this property, the materials are classified as hard materials and soft materials. Those materials which are difficult to compress or scratch are called hard materials. For example, iron, wood, stone or glass. These materials are very difficult to compress or scratch. The next are soft materials. Those materials which can be compressed or stretched easily are called soft materials. For example, rubber band, cotton, sponge, pillow, all these are very soft materials and they can be compressed or scratched very easily. So on the basis of this property also, we can select different materials for making particular object. Now the next property is solubility. On the basis of this property, materials are classified into two types: soluble materials and insoluble materials. Now, what are soluble materials? Those materials that completely disappear or dissolve in water are called soluble substances or soluble materials. For example, salt, sugar, vinegar, milk, honey. If you try to dissolve any one of these in water, so what will happen? Suppose you try to dissolve salt in water. So salt will completely disappear in water because it is soluble in water. So those substances that completely disappear or dissolve in water, they are called soluble substances. And insoluble substances, those substances that do not mix with water and do not disappear even after we stir for long. For example, sand, oil, kerosene, chalk, powder, etc. Suppose if you try to dissolve kerosene in water, so what will happen? Kerosene form a layer on the surface of water and it will not dissolve in water because it is insoluble in water. So some substances are soluble in water and some are insoluble in water. Next property is whether the material floats or sinks in water. Objects which are less denser or lighter than water will float in water. For example, twigs, plastic ball, paper boat, cotton balls, thermocol, all these are less denser than water, so they will float in water. And some objects which are more denser or heavier than water will sink in water. For example, sand, stone, coins, iron balls, etc. Suppose if you try to throw or if you throw a stone in water, so what will happen? Stone will sink in water. But if you try to throw cotton balls in water, so what will happen? Cotton ball are less denser than water, so cotton balls will float on water. So some materials will float in water and some will sink into it. Now the next property is transparency. On the basis of this property, materials are divided as or materials are classified as transparent materials, opaque materials and translucent materials. So let's start with transparent materials. Those materials through which things can be seen clearly are called transparent materials. For example, glass, water, air, etc. If you try to see through water or through a glass, so you can see clearly because these are transparent materials, and through these materials we can easily see. Now the next materials are opaque materials. Those materials through which things cannot be seen are called opaque materials. For example, wood, metals, cardboard, wall, tree, plastics, etc. If you try to see through a wooden door, so can you able to see? No, because through opaque materials we cannot be able to see. Now the next materials are translucent materials. Those materials through which things can be seen but not clearly are called translucent materials. For example, butter paper, oily patch on paper, etc. Suppose if you try to see through a butter paper, so you can see but not clearly. So butter paper is a translucent material because through the butter paper you can see but cannot see clearly. So all these properties help us to select a particular material to make a particular object. What are the properties? Appearance, hardness, solubility, whether the material floats or sinks in water, and its transparency. These properties are very helpful to select a particular material to make a particular object. Now, we have to understand that why sorting of materials or objects is needed. Dividing materials into groups makes it convenient to study their properties and observe any pattern in these properties. So, sorting is needed to study their properties and observe any pattern in these properties. So, I hope you have understood this chapter very well. Now, let's do some exercises. So, number one is the state of matter which has a definite volume but no definite shape. Solid, liquid, gas, or mixture. Solids have definite shape as well as the definite volume. Liquids have a definite volume but there is no definite shape. It will take the shape of the container in which it is kept in. So the answer is liquid. Next is, perfume is a substance which is volatile, non-volatile or malleable. So volatile means the substance which can easily changes into gas. So the answer is volatile because the perfume is a substance which is easily changes into gas. So answer is volatile. Now next are Phillips. All metals are dash of heat and electricity. So all metals are conductor of heat and electricity. Conductor means which conduct heat. Next is gold. Gold is dash. So gold is ductile. Ductile means which can be drawn into thin wires or sheets. That is why it is used to make jewelries. So it is ductile. Now, petrol is dash in water. Petrol is insoluble in water because it doesn't dissolve in water and form a layer on the surface of the water. So it is insoluble in water. Next is copper is dash magnetic material. So copper is electromagnetic material. Electromagnetic means which is having both electrical characteristic as well as the ability to attract the metals. So they are electromagnetic. They have both electrical as well as magnetic properties. So copper is a electromagnetic material. Now chalk does not dash in water. Chalk does not dissolve in water. Name two gases which are insoluble in water. So oxygen is soluble. Yes, it is soluble in water. Hydrogen is insoluble in water. And the next one is nitrogen. Nitrogen is also insoluble in water. So I hope you have understood this topic. Now thank you and see you in the next video.